Treta 17. It's called the vertical circle cut from first intention. So the first of all, they set up the initial one. It's we stand at right angle and engage the sword on the outside. We circle around this sword, and with a transverse step, we then curve step to throw a full cut. Briefly extend. So okay, so this first part's pretty easy. I'm taking my toe on the outside, and then I need to transverse. I can transverse either way. It says that I'm spiraling, it doesn't say which transverse. So I spiral around this one, I get here, and then I've got to take a curved step to my right, which it's explicit on, to deliver a cut. It's sort of like, I can kind of curve step to the right, but then I'm cutting with the engagement, and it's really only a half cut. So I don't think that's what they want. Similarly, if I take my engagement on the outside, spiral all the way around during my transverse out, and then I try and cut with another curve step. Once again, I'm either cutting a half cut or in subjection, and that doesn't seem good either. So that's what brought us to the maybe I don't have to spiral all the way around. It's like, how far do I spiral all around? And we came up with transverse to almost using extortion from this line. So I'll come around to the lower section, spell it out. I've finished my transverse, and now I'm going to go to the second step. That's kind of the best way to do it. The only sort of downside to that, or the questioning part, is like, why do I need a second step? That's it. If I'm doing my curve around, I can just deliver it straight away. As Gillian points out, maybe it's because I want a bit more distance around it and a bit more safety. Yeah. Talking about the counters, there's two counters that they cover. One says to subject it during the spiral, and then place your own attire and thrust to the right and go lateral. So now if I get Jillian to do the spiral on the other side, yep, as it comes around. So I think here the subjection in that third section is keep my sword in presence so I don't get expelled. And that allows me to do the attire. Okay, let's just do that again. So you see the difference here is as Julian spirals around to try and expel, I'm like firing out and subjecting it. Sometimes I'm ending up on the wrong side when I do that. I don't know if that's a feature or a problem. You can do the same sort of thing, but extend to the right angle and run away. So let's assume that they still finish it, but they just don't expel it away. So they come around, subject it here. So you still roll around to deliver your cut. I can then do the attire as they say, finish with my right angle and retreat out. And
alternate counter to that says to approach by the third way to apply an attire and conclude. So reading around about the third way, we're going to be trying to cut around into the attire on the outside. A little bit of risk.
So we'll just step back here so we can get second curve step when you're doing your cut, and I need to be accurate. So they're kind of all kinds of various versions of it, and it doesn't really feel like the nice little cut around that we're after. Usually I'm like fishing for that blade, trying to get around the blade. So we do a few more. Sometimes I'm like trying to conclude before I even stop it, and then it's more like just covering it out rather than cutting into it. Other times, it's just out of sequence and I kind of copy it in my head. So, yep, I'm not super happy with that interpretation, but I think that's probably the best thing to apply for that.